All right, Coach, we'll go ahead and get started.
Well, I wish I had words to express really how I feel right now, but obviously a tough way to end the season. Just proud of our guys for how hard they fought, but it's obviously tough and trying to find the words in the locker room to say goodbye to some guys that have given a lot to our programs. Very challenging, very difficult to do. But, you know, as you know, life is full of challenges. Obviously, tonight is disappointing, but I just try to tell the guys as much as I possibly can that you got to keep your head up. You got to keep your chin up. Life is full of adversity, and tough times never last. Tough people do. So just, you know, some of those guys have given so much to our program, and tough way to see it end tonight.
Coach, could you just, you know, take us into the locker room for a second? I mean, how did you find the words, or what did you say to some of those guys after a game like tonight?
It's very, very, very challenging. Obviously, you know, we finished the night in the locker room, just, you know, taking a knee together and, you know, saying a prayer, and you know, obviously trying to address the guys and make sure that, you know, it's very emotional, obviously, in the locker room. A lot of guys that, you know, crying tears of knowing that it's the last game that they're going to play here, Ball State. And so nobody knows for sure what the future holds with any of them. And it's just tough when you've given so much over the years, and to take the uniform off for the final time is emotional. So just, you know, I'm obviously, you know, when you lose, it's very challenging, but just try to encourage them that, you know, one day when you know, you try to reflect back, just think about so many of the positive things that, you know, they were able to accomplish in their career, not just on the field, but academically and getting a degree, some of them getting a master's, and to be able to go make a difference in the world and wherever it is they end up next. You know, the foundation that you built and put in place here, go take advantage of that and go be a difference maker in your community.
Sure. And then, you know, that fourth and one at midfield there at the end, what was kind of the decision making behind that, and what was kind of going, or your thought process?
Obviously, that's all on me. You know, I blame it on me. I'll take the blame, obviously, for the loss tonight. You know, we had a foot to go. I felt very, very good about the play call. I felt very good about the offensive line, and I felt very good about having what, in my opinion, is the best player in the league. And so I felt strongly about getting a foot. You know, obviously, you know, either way, you know, if we get that first down and we get a foot, then certainly we control the clock and potentially run it out. And you know, obviously, if not, then we punt and kick back to them. And obviously, they had a little bit of momentum based on the previous scoring drive on the previous possession. So I certainly understand that that's going to be scrutinized, and deservedly so. That falls on me. That was a decision I made, but I believe in our guys, and I felt strongly about being able to get a foot.
And obviously, you know, Kyle Kelly got some action tonight. What was that? What was the decision making there to, you know, give him some snaps? And how impressed with you or were you with, you know, the or how he took advantage of his opportunity?
Yeah, you know, obviously Kyle had a great week of practice. You know, he got a lot of reps in practice this week. John got dinged up in the game last week against Ohio. He finished it. When he scrambled, he banged up his shoulder there a little bit. So he was limited throughout the week of practice. And Kyle really stepped in and had a great week, and felt good about how we were going to utilize him and let him run, make some plays with his feet. And obviously, obviously made a nice throw there on the play there to Casey Call. So really, Kyle, it was nice to see him step in there, have a ton of confidence in him, and obviously to step in the way that he did, you know, in the 12th game of the year, a little bit chilly outside, to really take care of the ball the way he did was awesome. And it's good to see, because he provided a great spark and really did a nice job.
I thought the secondary, you know, for most of the night, they didn't allow a 20-plus yard pass until, you know, that that catch in the end zone. You know, how impressed with were you with them and just, you know, keeping you guys in the fight throughout the game?
I mean, obviously the defense did a great job all night long. You know, they did a good job just making it tough. A lot of tough yards out there that they made our obviously made Miami earn. And so, you know, it really it's so hard just because of how well we played for, you know, the better part of 3.5, almost 4 quarters there. And so, you know, it's comes down to the end in this league, in this conference, and tough way to end it. But, you know, you have to credit them for making a play there at the end. And, you know, our guys are in position, and, you know, Nick was in position there. And, you know, you just got to credit them for going to make a play.
And then obviously, you know, this season, you know, a couple close losses for you guys and a couple close wins as well. You know, as you kind of look back, you know, at the season, I mean, how would you evaluate how it went for you guys as a whole?
Yeah, you know, obviously, you know, after a little bit of time here to try to, you know, decompress, if you will, got to go back and take a deep look at it. You know, obviously, we know that there's a lot of one possession games that we've been in over the years. This game, this conference is full of a lot of one possession games every single week. So, you know, got to be better. You know, you got to win your, you got to win the one possession games. When you do win the one possession games, you have a chance to compete for a championship at the end of the year. When you don't win the one possession games and you're in a situation that we're in right now, you know, much the same way as we were, you know, back in that 2019 season when we, you know, we you know, lost a lot of the one possession games. So we've got to go back, and obviously there's, you know, things that we need to improve on. And, you know, first and foremost, the turnover margin, you know, we got to be able to win the turnover battle, especially late in the season when you're in some of these games that are going to decide whether or not you continue on and play after the 12th game.
So, yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
Coach, going into the second half, having that lead, what was the game plan for the second half, and where did that go wrong?
Yeah, the goal at halftime, we talked in the locker room, it's 0-0, fellas. Don't get caught looking at the scoreboard. We got to go out. We got to execute. We got to make sure that we're playing just as physical or more physical in the second half. And we got to put drives together. We got to sustain drives, you know, scored 3 points there, obviously, in the second half, which is not good enough. The first drive of the second half, we took it down. We scored 3 points, and we had some other drives there that you can't have holding penalties. You can't have self-inflicted wounds and get yourself into long yarded situation. Even on the first drive of the second half, we had a holding penalty. We converted a screen on third down and long that, you know, obviously continued the drive. But self-inflicted wounds down the stretch there offensively can't happen. Can't happen. And so we were called for them, you know, whether they haven't seen the tape yet, but we got called for those holds, and you know, that can't happen.
Where does the program grow? Where did you see the most growth from the program this season?
I mean, obviously we had a little, you know, bit of, you know, after we had a big transition last year, you know, we had 32 guys that really graduated and moved on to the next chapter of their life after last year. So big turnover, and obviously we were picked, you know, everybody had us picked at the bottom, but our guys fought their tail off every single week, gave ourselves a chance to be in position at the end of games, week in, week out. But you got to win those. You got to win those one possession games. There's guys that got a lot of playing experience for the first time. They practiced a lot over the years. They got a lot of playing experience, you know, in particular, John, you know, this first time playing a full season. So there's things that he's going to look back, and we'll look back on, and, you know, making a jump from this year to next year. And some of the things that the mistakes that were made, or some of the areas where you can improve on, you just got to, you know, that's what the off season, that's what spring practice, that's what, you know, that part of the process is for.
Then earlier today, it was announced that the winner of the game would play in the Bahamas Bowl. Do you think that added any pressure or any different angle to the game that might have affected the players?
No, I don't. I think, you know, that's the stage. That was the opportunity. That was what was put out there. We all got to respond to the challenge. If you know, nobody was asked to do something today that they didn't perform and practice all week long. So you play the way you practice. You know, there wasn't something that somebody was asked to come out here and do today. Nobody had to deliver any kind of heroic performance. You just got to do your job. You got to do your job with the best effort you got. And you got to play four quarters. And, you know, I was proud of the effort, proud of the fight. Obviously, they made a play at the end there. You know, we couldn't respond with a 2-minute drive there to give ourselves a chance to win.
Yeah, Carson, I guess just what's kind of the going on in the locker room and what's kind of being said amongst the guys after a game like that?
You know, it's hard. We shot ourselves in the foot and, you know, we just kind of had mistakes here and there. And, you know, you feel bad for the guys. You know, this is their last year playing football. You know, they'll never come out and step out on a field again, you know. So it's hard. It's emotional, you know, but we, you know, grinded out the season. You know, everybody tried to tell us we were going to finish last. You know, obviously it didn't go the way we wanted it, you know, but we, you know, showed our ups and showed our downs as well. So
what do you take away from this season? You know, there's the one possession wins and the one possession losses, obviously, like tonight. You know, I guess, you know, reflecting back at the whole season, how do you kind of evaluate how it went for you guys?
You know, it's kind of hard on us. We, like I just said, we were biting ourselves in the foot. You know, most of the time we were up almost a lot of the games that we lost, and just like this game tonight. And you know, we just had them let them come back and, you know, beat us by those, you know, last second, you know, points scored. And you know, it's kind of hard overall, but you know, we fought really hard this season. So
I mean, when you talk about kind of closing out some of those games, is it more of an execution thing or a mindset, or how do you guys kind of fix that, I guess, moving forward?
I would say a little bit of both. You know, we got to, you know, keep our minds straight, you know, realize, you know, there's a lot of game left, and obviously executing plays downfield, stuff like that, you know, getting stops, and then also, you know, letting balls fly, you know, being able to run, get first down, stuff like that, you know, that really kind of showed that, you know, throughout the season, you know, we were making mistakes here and there like that. So.
And obviously Kyle got, you know, some action tonight. Mm-hmm. What kind of element does he add to your guys' offense?
You know, he's a great athlete, and, you know, it was his first time ever playing a college football game, and, you know, shined. And, you know, that's a really amazing thing to do, you know, for a person to be able to come out, you know, and he took, you know, many reps during the week, you know, practice. You know, John, you know, had a little bit of a shoulder injury and was hurting really bad. But for him to come out, you know, that really just kind of tried to balance us out a little bit, gave me a break here and there running and stuff. And then, you know, John would come in and throw passes and stuff like that. Trying to have that more of a balanced offense, like I said, you know, the prior weeks, you know, we just couldn't get it done tonight, though.
That's all I got. Thank you.
When that final whistle went off and game over, season over, who'd you go to first on the field?
I would just probably say Will Jones. You know, that dude, he's helped me a lot throughout these couple last years, and you know, it's been hard. You know, it's his sixth year. You know, he's not coming back. He's never being able to get to play football again. So, you know, I just, you know, I came back this week after everything that happened last week, just trying to get a bowl game for him, and we couldn't get it done tonight. And so that kind of really hurt me, but you know, that's somebody who I look up to, and you know, is an inspiration for me. So,
and as you mentioned, potentially not even playing in this game, what was those few days like after last week's game where you were still day to day, Willy Woney? How does that kind of hit you mentally?
It was hard, you know, trying to balance out school and stuff, you know, being action, you know, those Tuesday games and stuff, but you know, coming in day by day, you don't know if you're going to be able to play or not, you know, really kind of messed me up a little bit mentally. But you know, I was just able to, you know, be with great trainers, great coaches. You know, they really helped me to push through and you know, figure out what I needed to do to be able to get back and play.
On that fourth and one play at midfield, what were you seeing on the field?
I just, you know, it wasn't anything I didn't see. It was just, you know, they fit up the gaps and stuff like that, and you know, it was kind of blurry, but I didn't really see much. And you know, it's unfortunate we just didn't get that play. So,
and finally, what's your top moment of the season?
Top moment of the season, just being around all these dudes, you know, I like to be a leader, try to be a leader at least here and there, but, you know, seeing some of these dudes come in and, you know, they get up in meetings and talk, you know, they're tough Cardinals, you know, our top dudes, they're really love watching them, you know, they inspire me, you know, and just like I said, Will Jones as well too, you know, being able to watch him, you know, I used to watch him back when I was in high school, he ran around a little bit here and, you know, being able to grow up with him as well. You know, and Trevor Holt, he went to Center Grove and, you know, he hung around Will and stuff like that. Being around those dudes just kind of, you know, inspired me to be able to come to Ball State, you know, fit right in with these guys and, you know, be around them throughout this season. So,
you know, obviously, you know, tough way for the game and the season to end. What's kind of being said in the locker room amongst the guys after a game like that?
You know, it's tough. Not a lot. Not a lot, really, to be honest. That was my last game with my older brother. So I came in late with him. Just not a lot was said. Coach didn't talk to us. You know, hats off to the seniors. Those guys did a lot for this program. It meant a lot to me, meant a lot to him, meant a lot to the other coaches. But honestly, not a lot. It's one of those moments that you will remember for the rest of your life because it was dead silent, upset, mad, sad, whatever you want to look at it as.
Yeah, obviously, you know, the defense, you know, stepped up again tonight and, you know, limited the big plays until that one, you know, late in the game. I guess, you know, when you see the Miami receiver kind of come down with that, what's kind of going through your head, I guess?
I don't know, you know, turning, looking, seeing that happen. It's just another 50-50 ball, another football play. You're pretty pissed. And then kind of snaps back to reality. Look at the clock. So there's like 1:40 left. They're going to go for two, try to make a 3-point game. Just know, let's stop this 2-point conversion and just get the ball back in offense hands and have faith. I try not to get too worked up. I mean, I could get mad. We could all get mad, but it just doesn't do any good at that point. So, you know, you want to get mad, you want to get upset that our defense just let them score, but we had a job to do to stop them on 2-point conversion to give our offense a chance to go kick a field goal to win it. But that's about it.
How much, you know, when you look back at this season, you know, we talk about the 50-50 balls a lot, you know, I mean, how much of the season really came down to just some of those, you know, 50-50 plays in some of the close games?
I mean, you take a look at scratch Tennessee, scratch Murray State, Ohio-ish, everything else was a one possession game. So an interception here, a pass breakup, a PI, a touchdown on those 50-50 balls can change our whole season. I said it a couple weeks or last week, you know, we could be whatever and two, whatever and one right now. If we kind of come up with some of those plays down long lines, it's not even all 50-50 balls. It's not even, I look at that as more of a metaphor. I mean, there's some special team stuff that could have gone right, could have gone wrong, offense, defense. But I think that's just the epitome of football. I mean, it's a game of inches. It's going to come down to some small, minute details. And this season's gone, had its ups and downs, but we had a chance and we didn't execute that chance late in the fourth.
How do you kind of, you know, when you look back at this season, how do you kind of evaluate the season? Obviously, you know, you guys were picked last at the beginning. You know, people might not have even thought you guys would be in this position to potentially, you know, reach a bowl game. But then, you know, there were a lot of those one possession games. I guess as you look back, I mean, you know, how do you think the season went for you guys overall?
You know, the fact that we were picked last, no disrespect to anybody that makes those lists, votes on those lists. No disrespect, but I don't look at them. I don't look at them when we're up top. I don't look at them when we're at the bottom. I think the first time I found out that we were at the bottom was Mac Media days when you told me. And that's somebody's job. It gets voted on, however, whatever. But this conference is so up and down and all over the place that those rankings don't matter to me personally. I'm going to go about it the same way, whether we're at top or the bottom. But this season in a whole, I'll never say I'm disappointed that we didn't get to where we wanted to. Didn't get to a MAC championship, had a small chance. Didn't get to a bowl game, had our chance tonight. Disappointed, I guess, is a word, but not the right word in my opinion. I try to learn from everything that we've done and try to move on. Obviously, this one hurts. So I'm going to be upset for a while. I'll never look at Miami, Ohio the same after this. But I think at the same time, I'm grateful for the opportunity that I had to play football, to play football with my brothers, some of my best friends on this team, guys that were in my wedding that I had, guys that if I needed something, I could call. So it's just a blessing to play the game. Disappointed in the outcome, the record. I think we're a better team than 5-7, but we obviously didn't show that, didn't prove that. So just a lot of mixed emotions.
Oh, yeah, thank you.
Obviously going into half up by 11, what was the game plan like? What was talked about for going out in that second half and what kind of went wrong?
I think the game plan was to keep going. Don't let up. Get them to third down and let's get after them. They struggled on third down. That quarterback's not a real passing quarterback as much as Gabbard is. Now, he obviously threw some balls tonight that were successful, but their MO last week against Northern was running the ball with him. A little bit different offense compared to him and Gabbard, but let's keep doing what we're doing because it's working. And then they just kind of got out there and chipped away at us and started doing some things. Nothing that was outside of our game plan that we couldn't handle. It's just a couple plays here and there that we need to come up with if we want to win this game.
How did this program grow this year, and how do you guys take it into next year?
You know, there's been some turnovers in the last couple of years with COVID and how things have worked. And there's been a lot of guys that have stepped up. And I couldn't be more proud to see some of the younger guys really fulfilling their roles and stepping up and seeing what it's like to buy in. So I'm just grateful and I'm excited for the future for my last year and then for years to come, because I know there's a lot of young guys that have worked really hard.
When that final whistle goes off, game over, season over, who did you go to first on the field?
Pretty much to my knees. And then look for my brother. There's a lot of people coming up to me, a lot of people around me, but my brother's last high school game, we got beat in sectionals. We walked off the field together, so I knew that this was going to be the final time for real, so I wanted to walk off with him.
And what was that conversation like?
Just a tough one. One that I knew was possible, but I did not want to have it. I knew what it was like in high school, and I didn't want to go through it again, so it was a tough one.